So today I will be discussing about the first chapter of class 9, that is India size and location. So when we say India, we all know that it is one of the most ancient civilization in the whole world, and it has been achieving tremendously in different fields like agriculture, industry, technology and overall economic development. And also it have contributed much to the world history. Now coming to the chapter, before going deeper into it, let us remind what we have studied in our earlier classes. So latitudes and longitudes, okay, for referring this chapter in geography, you have to be very, very clear with latitudes and longitudes. As we all know, latitudes are the horizontal or parallel lines to the equator, okay, and longitudes, this latitudes run from north to south, and longitudes run from east to west, okay, and in total we have 180 latitudes. Towards the north we have 90, towards the south we have 90, and in total we have 360 longitudes. Towards the west we have 180, towards the east we have 180. Okay, and I think if you remember international dateline, that is 180 degree east or west, okay. So that is the international dateline, and we are ahead than the western countries by one day, okay, because sun rises earlier in the east. Okay, so eastern country, as you know, that sun rises in the east. So from like deeper into the subject we'll know, but just let me give an idea that this is the prime meridian, okay, this is the prime meridian or the Greenwich meridian. And the time actually considered from here. So this particular line is like ahead from India by 5 hours 30 minutes. So suppose you are here in India. Now what is the time? You can check it. Exactly after 5.5 hours, that time you will see in London. Okay. Because each longitude have a difference of 4 minutes, and if you go from one longitude to another, then obviously that finally you will, when you will reach from here to prime meridian, it will be 5 and 30 hours late. Okay, so now coming back to the chapter, so be very clear what is latitude and longitude, because throughout the chapter you have to be very, very clear about this. So latitudes are the parallel lines and longitudes are the horizon vertical lines. Now India's location. When we say India's location, where India is located, India's latitude is 8 degree 4 minute north, okay, to 37 degree 6 minute north. This is the latitude of India. And its longitude is 68 degree 7 minute east to 97 degree 25 minute east. Now, India lies in the northern hemisphere, you know that. And already we have studied about the latitude and longitude, which makes a difference of 30 degrees. And Tropic of Cancer divides India into two equal halves. Now, the landmass, okay. The total landmass of India is about 3.28 million square kilometer, which means it shares only 2.4% to the whole world, and it is the seventh largest country in the world. Okay, the land boundary of India, this is the land boundary from here up till, let me show you, up till here, okay. So this is the land boundary, and land boundary is 15,200 kilometer. The coastline, this is the coastline, okay. If you forgot, let me remind you, coastlines are the lines which joins the sea, the coastal areas, it is in the coastal area which joins the sea, okay. So this is the coastline, and the coastline of India including our islands, that is Andaman and Nicobar Island and Lakshadweep Island, we have 7516. From north to south, is 3,214 kilometers from Jammu and Kashmir to Kanyakumari, okay? And from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh, it is 2,933 kilometers. Clear? Next, we all know that, though we maintain the same time, but actually we have a difference of 2 hours from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh, okay? But why do we have, how can we prove that, actually there is a difference of 2 hours? We can prove that because already I have told you that there is a difference of 30 longitudes. That means the whole India, if you see the map again, this whole India, okay, if you just subtract both the latitudes and longitudes, approximately we'll get 30 degrees. That means in total we have 30 degrees of longitudes in India. And each longitude, suppose from one longitude to another longitude, when it moves, it requires 4 minutes. Okay, so here I have given the mathematical calculation. So the time taken by sun to cross one longitude is 4 minutes. Okay, and difference in longitude, this is our easternmost, this is our westernmost, so 97 degree to 67 approximately is 30 degree. So therefore 30 into 4, 30 longitudes into 4 minutes is equals to 120 minutes. And if you calculate this in hour, you will get it as 2 hours. So hence it is proved that from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh, there is a difference of 2 hours. But to avoid certain confusion of timing, we all follow the same time. Okay. Now, India, okay, starts to taper from 22 degree north. From 22 degree north, it tapers towards the south and meets the Indian Ocean. And that is why, Indian Ocean have taken the name from India actually. Because such a long coastline, no other countries share with Indian Ocean. Okay, it is only India. So that is why Indian Ocean have taken its name from India. Now, India and the world, the relation of India with the world. So, India have a very good relation with the whole world. Okay, starting from the past time, it have good relation through the land routes. Towards the north, it have the land routes, and towards the south, it have the oceanic routes. So there are various passes in this northern part through which the ancient travelers used to move from India to the world and from world to India, sharing their ideas. For example, I can give you the different commodities we have shared with the world or we have taken from the world. Like the ideas of Upanishads, the Ramayana, the Panchatantra and the Indian numericals, we all have, even the decimal system. Okay, the whole world use it. Okay, why? Because our ancient historians, mathematicians, etc., they used to travel to different parts and they used to share their ideas with the whole world. And similarly, from other countries also, we take certain ideas. For example, whatever in architecture you see today, okay, or you can see the architectural style of the dome and the grip sculpture we have in India. This have been taken from the international countries. And also, spices, muslin and other merchandise have been taken from India to other countries. Okay, so it shows that how India is having a very good relation with the whole world. Now next comes India's neighbor. Okay, before that, you all know that India have 28 states and 8 union territories. Okay, so now India shares its land boundary. This is the land boundary. The green in shade, these are all land, and the blue is water. So India shares its boundary in the northwest with Pakistan and Afghanistan, and China, then Nepal, Bhutan in the north, Myanmar and Bangladesh in the east. Okay, our southern neighbors, that is two island countries we have. Okay, one is Maldives, another one is Sri Lanka. Clear? So Sri Lanka is separated by India through a very small narrow corridor, and the name of that corridor is Park Strait, okay, and the Gulf of Mannar. While Maldives, okay, this is towards the south of Lakshadweep. And India have a very strong relation, and you before, like, there was a history in India, like before 1947 there were two types of states in India. One was princely state, other was the province state. Now we all are under government, but earlier it was not like that. Okay, so this is all about India, its size and location. So thank you.